Welcome back. We have completed nomenclature of halocompounds now. Now, preparation of halocompounds. First one from alcohol. We can prepare alkyl halide from alcohols. The hydroxyl group of an alcohol is replaced by halogen on reaction with the concentrated halogen acid like HCl or phosphorus halides like PCl3 or PBr3 or sometimes PCl5 and thionic chloride, that is SOCl2. The preparation of alkyl chloride is carried out either by passing dry halogen chloride gas through a solution of alcohol or by heating a solution of alcohol in concentrated aqueous acid. The reaction of primary and secondary alcohols with the hydrogen halide like HCl require the presence of a catalyst that usually we are using zinc chloride as a catalyst. For example, ROH. ROH is a primary alcohol. When treating with the HCl in presence of zinc chloride, you are getting RCl plus H2O. If you are taking secondary alcohol like RCH, R-OH, no? On treating with the HCl in presence of zinc chloride, you will get RCH R-Cl plus H2O. In the case of tertiary alcohol, we need only shaking of that reacting mixture, that is tertiary alcohol, with the concentrated hydrochloric acid, and simply shaking, you will get a tertiary halocompound plus water. Alkyl bromide can be prepared by constant boiling of alcohol with HBr, hydrogen bromide, or by treating it with sodium bromide and sulfuric acid. ROH plus NaBr plus H2SO4 giving RBr plus NaHSO4 plus H2O. Second one, with the phosphorus halides. The alcohol, when treating with phosphorus trifluoride halides, you will get alkyl halide plus H3PO3. Here we can use PCl3 for formation of RCl, and if you are using PBr3, you will get RBr. Okay. Instead of using PX3, you can use PCl5. So ROH plus PCl5 give RCl plus POCl3 plus HCl. Phosphorus tribromide and triiodide are usually generated by the reaction of red phosphorus with bromine and iodine respectively. ROH, when treating with red phosphorus and X2, you are getting RX, where X may be bromine or iodine. The preparation of alkyl chloride from alcohol with the thionic chloride is preferred than with the HCl or with the phosphorus chloride, because the product obtained other than alkyl chloride are escapable gases. So it will escape and you are getting pure alkyl halide. So the reaction is ROH plus SOCl2 giving RCl plus SO2 plus HCl. Here SO2 and HCl are gases, so you can easily get RCl. You can get pure RCl. Okay. Good yield of alkyl halide, RI, may be obtained by heating alcohol with the sodium and potassium iodide in 95% phosphoric acid. The order of reactivity of alcohols with the given halo acid is tertiary greater than secondary greater than primary. These methods are not applicable for the preparation of aryl halides because the carbon and oxygen bond, no, carbon oxygen bond in phenol has a partial double bond nature, and so it is very difficult to break. You can see the resonating structure there, no? Second one from hydrocarbon by
free radical halogenation.
Last year we have studied free radical mechanism of halogenation. No, free radicals are formed when exposed to UV light or by heating. That is free radical chlorination or bromination of alkenes gives a complex mixture of isomeric mono and polyhalo alkenes. The product obtained is very difficult to separate. Example: CS3, CS2, CS2, CS3. On heating with the chlorine or exposure to UV light, you will get CS3, CS2, 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 Cl. That is, one hydrogen is replaced by a chlorine atom. Plus CS3, CS2, CHCl, CS3. You get a mixture of these two compounds and it is very difficult to separate out. Next, by electrophilic substitution. Aryl chlorides and aryl bromide can be easily prepared by electrophilic substitution of aryls with the chlorine or bromine respectively in the presence of Lewis acid catalyst like iron or ferric chloride. So toluene, in treating with the halogen, in presence of iron, you are getting ortho and para substituted toluene. These products can be easily separated because of the large difference in their melting point. In the case of iodination, for preparing aryl iodide, it requires an oxidizing agent such as HNO3 or HIO4 to oxidize hydrogen iodide form during iodination. This reaction is, that means the iodination, no, is reversible in nature. So in order to avoid the backward reaction, the byproduct obtained, that is hydrogen iodide, is oxidized using an oxidizing agent. Next one, a named reaction, Sandbach reaction. When a primary aromatic amine dissolved in called aqueous mineral acid is treated with the sodium nitrite, diazonium salt is formed. This freshly prepared diazonium salt is mixed with the cuprous chloride or cuprous bromide. You will get the respective aryl halide. Aniline, when treating with sodium nitrite plus HX, that is called the nitrous acid. You are getting nitrous acid by mixing sodium nitrite plus HX. Okay, at a particular temperature, the temperature given as 278 Kelvin, you are getting benzene diazonium halide. This benzene, freshly prepared benzene diazonium halide, treated with the cuprous halide, you are getting aryl halide plus nitrogen, where X may be chlorine or bromine. If we want iodoarenes, then mix that diazonium salt with potassium iodide. So that freshly prepared benzene diazonium salt is treated with the potassium iodide, you are getting iodobenzene. That is Sandbach reaction, that is very important one. And the next one from alkenes. Okay, so addition of hydrogen halides in alkenes. Hydrogen halides used are HCl, HBr or HI. Alkenes treated with the hydrogen halide to form haloalkenes. Here simply addition reaction is taking place. That means an alkene, if it is symmetrical, it's very easy to add, you know, an alkene plus HX, you are getting an addition product. Simply adding hydrogen and iodine there by breaking the double bond. Okay. For an unsymmetrical alkene, we have to follow Markovnikov's rule for the addition reaction. We know that for addition of unsymmetrical alkene, the positive part of the addendum or adding species will attach to the carbon atom which have more number of hydrogen atom. That is Markovnikov's rule. For example, CS3, CH double bond CS2. This is an example for unsymmetrical alkene. When treating with hydrogen iodide, That is an addition reaction, no? So you are getting CH3 CHICH3 as a major product, and CH3 CH2 CH2I as a minor product. Here what is happening? The positive part of hydrogen iodide, which is the positive part, hydrogen H+ and I minus, no? So positive part of hydrogen iodide H+ will move to that carbon atom which having maximum number of hydrogen. So look at the alkene part, the double bonded carbon atoms. So 1, 2 carbon atoms having double bond, no? For the first carbon atom, carbon number 1 having 2 hydrogen and carbon number 2 having only 1 hydrogen. So maximum hydrogen atom present in the first carbon atom. So the positive part, that is H+, will move to or attach to the first carbon atom, and you are getting CH3, CHI, CH3 as the major product along with the opposite one. That is CH3, CH2, CH2I also you are getting as a minor product. Okay. Second one from alkenes, by addition of halogens. Addition of bromine in CCl4 result in the synthesis of vicinal dibromide, which are colorless. For example, CH2 double bond CH2 plus bromine in CCl4, you are getting vicinal dibromide. The addition of bromine in CCl4 used as a test for saturation, or we can say that it is used for detection of double bond in qualitative analysis. The reddish brown color of bromine become colorless. That is the test by forming vicinal dibromide. Third one, halogen exchanges. Alkyl iodide can be prepared by the reaction of alkyl chloride or alkyl bromide with the sodium iodide in dry acetone. This reaction is known as Fingersten reaction. Rx plus Nai in dry acetone, you are getting Ri plus Nax. Here, the exchange of X and iodine will is taking place. So you are getting Ri, alkyl iodide. This NaS formed is precipitate in dry acetone. We can increase the forward reaction according to Lee-Chartres principle. Alkyl fluorides are prepared by heating alkyl chlorides or alkyl bromide in presence of a metallic fluoride like AgF, COF2 or SbF3. This reaction is known as Schwartz reaction. CH3Br plus AgF giving CH3F plus Ag. So these are the method of preparation of haloalkenes. In the next video, we will study about the physical and chemical properties of haloalkenes. Thank you for watching.